What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and yes, I finally hooked up the ThinkSystem SE350 from Lenovo, which is a super small edge server, very powerful. This guy has around 256 gigs of memory, two power supplies, got it hooked up, and I hooked up the XCC port with a Ethernet cable, VGA, and at the back, we have connected a mouse and a keyboard, because today we are going to configure this guy with a RAID configuration. So I'm super excited. We are going to power it on, which the power button is actually located right here at the top. It's actually blinking green. Let's turn this guy on real quick. And we can hear that power. Beautiful. I'm gonna let this guy boot up. Look at the screen real quick. We should see like the ThinkSystem. There it goes. ThinkSystem kind of BIOS menu. And we're going to head to the lab and we are going to enter the XClariy controller portal so we can log in and start configuring our RAID system on the ThinkSystem SE350. So let's get to it. ThinkSystem SE350 is up and running with no problem. Awesome. So let's get right into the RAID configuration, which is super simple. So you are going to find a machine that is part of the same network as your SE350 Edge server. On the desktop, you are going to open up your favorite browser. It's up to you. I am going to open up Google Chrome, super easy. And on the address bar, you are going to type in the IP address of the BMC controller of that server. On the unboxing and first impressions of the video, we configured the IP address of 115. Hopefully you guys checked out that video because I gave you kind of a quick glimpse of how to configure the IP address on that video, okay? So we are going to hit enter. You're going to get your connection is not private, which is okay. Click on advanced. And we're going to click on the link that says proceed to this particular IP address. Click on it. It's going to take you here to the XClariy controller. Now, the username and password would be user ID or caps. And the password would be password capitalized, but the O is a zero. Once you enter that information, click on login. It takes you here. Awesome. All green check marks, healthy, the way it's supposed to be on the server, right? On your left-hand side, we are going to click on server configuration, and there's the option. How simple is that? Click on RAID setup. Now, within RAID setup, it takes you directly to a RAID configuration, but I want to click on storage inventory, and this gives you a nice little bird's eye view of, you know, the type of hard drives that I have. Now, Lenovo was nice enough to send me a SE350 Edge server with only two M.2 solid state drives with only 480 gigs, which is not that bad. That means I can't do like a RAID 5 or a RAID 10. All right, so let's head back inside the RAID configuration. And within the RAID configuration on your right-hand side, you're going to see a hyperlink that says enable edit mode. We're going to click on it. Now we are inside edit mode. And we are going to click on virtual disk 1. I just want to see what's already configured. Again, Lenovo gave me this machine with a virtual disk already configured with a RAID 1. So I'm going to close it. I'm going to click on that trash icon. And I want to actually remove the selected virtual disk. So let's click on remove. It's going to start deleting the virtual disk. At the very top of the web portal, it is going to state delete virtual disk success. Awesome. From here, on your right-hand side, you see an option that says controller actions. We're going to click on it, and you only have two options, clear RAID configuration or manage foreign configuration. I'm going to click on clear RAID configuration. You're going to get this nice little warning, and I'm going to click apply. If everything works well, at the very top of the web portal, you're going to get clear RAID success, which is a good thing. Now it's time for us to create our virtual disk. I know Lenovo gave me this machine with a virtual disk already created, but I just wanted to show you guys how to create one yourself. So we are going to click on create virtual disk. You get a nice little menu right here. Let's start with get started. We are going to click on the drop down menu. We only have one option, so I'm gonna leave it as the default. And then the second option is pick your RAID. Now, because I only have two hard drives or two M.2 hard drives, we only have RAID 0 and RAID 1. So I'm going to pick RAID 1. And from here, I am going to select my hard drives. And I'm going to click on the button that says add members. And it's going to move it to the right hand side. How simple is that? And then we are going to click on next. Now, the second step is to create your virtual disk. You do have the option to click on the pencil and to make
extra modifications, but I'm gonna leave everything as the default and then click on next here. You get a nice little summary on step three, and then you click on the button that says start creating, and it's gonna start creating your new virtual disk, and then voila, you're done. Once you're happy with your virtual disk and you finalized it, the next thing that we need to do on the right-hand side, we're going to click on change to read-only mode. Click on that, and now you're done. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Also, smash that subscribe button, and do not forget about hitting that notification bell to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.